Last year's decathletes were special. They set the bar high. That makes the next solar decathlon even harder to win and more exciting to be part of. The university teams applying to the 2013 event started working on their entry proposals a year ahead of time because the entry is so difficult and competitive. Today, we are pleased to announce the selections. I'll start with the California teams. Boy, I wish I could be there to see their reaction when their names are called. SCI-Arc Caltech. Santa Clara University.
Welcome to the heart of Silicon Valley. We are Santa Clara University.
We are going to win because we're the best.
We have fantastic resources, a great group of engineers, and we have the diehard motivation.
One of the main reasons I chose to go to Santa Clara was because of the solar house. So I was so excited to learn that we made it into the 2013 competition.
It has such national and international attention.
We've already made connections with companies around the Silicon Valley.
We're the only team competing in 2013 that has placed. We took third place in the 2007 and 2009 competition, and we plan to take first in the 2013 competition.
I think the other teams are going to have to bring their top game for this competition, otherwise they're going to be in last place.
SCU! SCU!
Yeah! University of Southern California.
Hey, Mom.
Thanks for calling me back.
Yes, Mom, I got your cookies.
Anyway, you're never gonna believe this.
Remember how I told you about the Solar Decathlon competition we've been working on?
We just found out that USC's been accepted.
We've been working on it for several weeks already.
But it's a relief to know that we are in it now.
Everyone here is so excited.
Woo!
The whole school is supporting our team.
Hey, sorry, but I gotta run.
My instructor is calling.
Can everyone stop? Can everyone stop celebrating and get back to the studio and work on this thing?
And Stanford University.
As a first-time competitor, we've already hit the ground running, and we've made significant progress in the past few months. We don't want to just design a house that wins the competition. We've set our sights on a much higher goal, an idea that will really change the building industry. For now, I think our excitement is controlled. It's embodied in the way we professionally collaborate, the way we brainstorm, and the way we manage our responsibilities. But every once in a while, we'll let it show.
Go Stanford!
Missouri S&T. University of Nevada at Las Vegas.
We're in the desert, baby. This is what we do.
We're very excited to get in. This is great for the engineering college as well as the architecture college. We're all going to work together and just have a great time.
It's an amazing opportunity for us to learn and grow from this experience.
It's great to be involved within the community, to represent the Mojave Desert in Southern Nevada. And it's a good learning tool for all of us.
I'm glad we're in Vegas.
Yeah.
Very proud.
1, 2, 3, go, go Team Vegas!
Woo!
Go Team Vegas!
Viva Las Vegas!
We're coming, baby. We're coming for the rest of the teams.
Go Team Vegas!
Woo! Vegas!
Norwich University.
Really?
Awesome!
Motivation!
Destiny!
Ballin'!
Yes!
Booyah!
Woo! Awesome!
We're designing and building everything ourselves.
It's our responsibility.
It's our responsibility
to show that high-performance solar-powered dwellings.
Solar-powered dwellings.
Can be really affordable.
Can be both really affordable and just drop-dead beautiful.
Drop-dead beautiful.
Drop-dead beautiful.
And just drop-dead beautiful.
We are going to crack the code of affordable, high-performance, solar-powered dwellings.
Oh, yeah!
Our two European teams, the Czech Technical University from the Czech Republic.
Thanks, Joe. Hey, congratulations, everyone. You've been selected to participate in the Solar Decathlon 2013.
Team Austria.
I think all our team is really excited to participate. What do you think sets us apart from all the other teams?
I think we have a unique perspective. We have a lot of technical capacity. We have a very strong team filled with architects and engineers. We're coming from a more European background, and I think that sets us apart, actually. Austria has a very long tradition and history, especially in passive house and solar energy. Our team is going to win because we are very dedicated to the goal. As a first entrant in this competition, I think we have a lot to prove. It's going to really motivate us.
How would you describe our decathlon house?
Efficient, aesthetic. Built to last.
Team Austria!
West Virginia University.
What was your initial reaction to being accepted into the 2013 Solar Decathlon?
Yay! After this competition, you'll be saying, West Virginia? You mean like green energy from WVU? Alright, so why are we doing this again?
We got accepted into the Solar Decathlon.
Wait, what?
WVU got accepted into the Solar Decathlon.
It really is an accomplishment to actually be accepted into this because it is our first time.
Team Capital DC.
Today we found out that we actually got into competition and it's going to be in Irvine, California.
No way!
Tim.
Charlotte.
Corin.
Amanda.
And we're the architecture students from the Catholic University of America.
Jeremy.
I'm Bryant.
I'm Claire.
I'm Bobby.
And we're proud to be building a house for a veteran.
We're donating it to the organization of Soldier On.
Hi, I'm Katie.
I'm Kyle.
I'm Kristen.
And we're Team Capital DC.
And we're going to win!
And the fact that we got selected one of 20 teams is absolutely incredible.
Not only are we focusing on the solar decathlon, but we have a real client in mind.
Our team's going to win because we're not only designing a house for an actual client, but we're having all these integrated technologies. We want to have architecture not just be static. We want something in motion and something integrated and really shows off our school.
We are involved with George Washington University and American University, as well as ourselves, Catholic University. We do represent the nation's capital, and we're excited to show what we have to offer.
Team Arizona and New Mexico.
A hot, passive solar heating lighting approach into the design.
Well, that depends on what kind of limitations we have in transportability of the building itself, because, you know, we can use elements of mass.
The cactus, and the cactus, it holds a lot of water in its core. It's actually very rich in water as a plant.
Hey guys, we got it. We're in Solar Decathlon 2013.
All right. Did he hear that?
Team Texas. Team Tidewater, Virginia. Middlebury.
Nestled between Vermont's green and white mountains, where a liberal arts perspective aids in creative problem solving, Middlebury as both a college and a community sees Solar Decathlon as an opportunity to share our vision about a sustainable future on a global stage.
How excited are you for Solar Decathlon? Maybe I should ask someone else.
I got to participate in the last competition, and it was just one of, like, the greatest experiences of kind of my life. And I am so, so, so excited.
Stevens Institute of Technology.
I was grading design reports when I heard the great news.
I was in the theater when I found out.
I was sitting in class.
I was at swim practice.
The 2013 Solar Decathlon. Wow.
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 Wow. I'm so ready for this. It's a teaching home for children and adults.
A continuation of the classroom.
Families are going to learn from our home.
Learn how to save energy.
How to maximize efficiency.
How to go green.
It's going to be incredible.
From innovation to redefining excellence.
From our vision
to the global community.
A smarter today.
A smarter today.
A smarter today.
For a better tomorrow.
Stevens Institute of Technology.
Team Kentucky and Indiana.
Everybody, we did it!
Yeah, I can't wait to go to California because I am freezing.
Oh my gosh, this is amazing.
I'm so excited about this competition. I started 2 years ago. In 2009, I accidentally came upon this competition called Solar Decathlon, and I wanted to learn more about it. The more that I learned, the more that I read about it, the more I wanted to be a part of it. And I wanted to bring it to the University of Louisville because this is such a great opportunity for us.
Because it's a great opportunity to bring the research I've done in the lab to real world applications.
Really sweet because that's where we're going in the world. That's what we got to do.
I think we're going to win. I just want to say because we're awesome.
We have the knowledge.
We have the heart. We have the resources.
We're dedicated.
We have teamwork. One, two, three.
Teamwork!
And mad model making skills.
Why are you going to win the Solar Decathlon? Why not?
UNC Charlotte.
Oh, really? Wow, that's great news.
Hi, guys.
Congratulations, we got it! Solar Decathlon 2013.
Yeah!
When we first learned that we got accepted into the Solar Decathlon, it was just a great joy because we've had so much fun working on the projects thus far. And
this is a great opportunity that's going to allow students from multiple disciplines to come together as a team to achieve a common goal.
It's something I've been looking forward to for a really long time, and we're looking forward to showing you what we have to offer.
You can put the entire university on the map on a national scale.
And of course, be able to reach out to the communities about the sustainable goals.
Even more excited about going to Southern California.
Finally, our two Canadian teams, University of Calgary.
We are communications.
We are architecture.
We are sponsorship and finance.
We are engineering.
We are environmental design.
We are Team Alberta. We believe in affordable and sustainable living for all.
We'll see you in California.
And Team Ontario.
Guiding SE 2013.